Oh, what do you
attention,
want?
Attention.
Scram.
Please handle relics carefully. In case of damage, your life will be forfeit.
What do you want? Bye-bye.
I'm listening. I'm all ears. Bye-bye.
Hello.
The highway leading to C-12 Nashville is blocked by an anomalous storm, and you're forced to detour over a mountain pass. Soon, the radiator boils over, and you have to stop. Clara lifts up the hood and thoroughly examines the steaming radiator.
The engine's boiling, so we'll have to wait. You do know what happens when a car boils, right?
The blue shuts her mouth abruptly and stares anxiously at the dark funnel cloud dancing on the horizon. Now that you're on higher ground, it's clear that the storm has overtaken a fairly large section of road. It will be difficult to pass. The blue looks at the engine again.
We wait. As soon as it cools down, we'll go. This storm worries me more, but it's not an insurmountable problem. I heard there are some relics at the local gas station that protect against anomalies. You could even accidentally step on one out here, they say. Mysterious are the ways of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still tweaking out.
Just get some sleep. That's all you need.
That's the thing. I don't want to sleep. Those whites sure know their chemistry. What did they add in there anyway?
Some kind of stimulator? Or maybe some forefather stuff? Why do you even care, honey?
A weird, scruffy old man with a matted beard is sitting in front of the checkout terminal. The badge on his blue jumpsuit is long since bleached away. The name Aaron Melville is written there in black marker. With a groan, he picks up a magnifying glass and, peering through it, begins poking at the keyboard with one knobby finger. The computer plays a short tune. Checkmate, the system declares. The old man angrily sets the magnifying glass aside.
A grandmaster? You're a piece of junk, not a grandmaster. And a cheater to boot.
He raises his head to squint in your direction.
Eh? What do you want? I don't advise eating here, and there's nothing to buy. And either way, we're closed.
The shopkeeper rises from his seat, and you notice he's sporting a peg where his left leg should be. The old man throws up his hands with a scowl.
Oh, then go fix it.
Melville reluctantly points a crooked finger at the front door.
Go out there and walk over to the gas station. Go down to the basement. There's an anomaly, a tree. It's glowing. And there are some golden thingies hanging off it. We make special devices from that fruit called anomaly protectors. Could one be...
After a little digging, he pulls out a little key on a shoelace.
Only take the device, you hear? It's company property. I should be charging you myself, as a matter of fact.
Salutations. Come back again.
Glad to meet you. See ya.
Thank you.
I'll make research samples out of you.
It'll be more effective.
Make research samples.
I'm warning you. I know Kung Fu.
I'll poke you in the eye with my shank.
Damn! Need to reload.
I'll smack you up.
I'll definitely get promoted.
I'm warning you. I know Kung Fu.
Thank you.
you think it's right to feed capitalists just so they can...
Thank you.